Like, this is one of the few things that actively, massively pisses me off, because for a long time I've been thinking that Wizards' internal testing process is not competitive in the first place. I often think it's really just like a thing to make them feel better about themselves, especially when the people testing the cards are also the ones designing the cards. There's like an inherent like friction there. Yeah, we're probably using this. Also, this is pretty sick. No, there was no Zoltar guy. There was actually a dragon guy, and we lost to them. Create a food token. Oko is cooking. Baju. Guess another replica, another natural order? No. Is there any... It's interesting that they didn't put the thing in their hand, so I would think they have another Force Foil. Either another Force Foil or a snake. Oh, there was TSL earlier today. Like, I don't really watch TSL for StarCraft 2 anymore, and I'm not really into StarCraft 2. Like, I guess sometimes if it's on, I might put it on, but, like, I don't know too much about StarCraft 2. Like, I don't even know all the units. Like, I used to be really heavily into it during Rings of Liberty, and somewhat during Heart of the Swarm, but not really. And then they have like creatures like adepts, and I don't know what they do, but they can somehow teleport. Is that speak now? I'm not so sure about that. Especially with Brood War like outshining StarCraft 2 so much. Like, I think StarCraft 2 was... Yeah, I think StarCraft 2 really was its peak in between 2010 and 12. Because back then, it was like the number one esport, almost like number one esport right now. It really, like, led the revolution on Twitch and everything. It's still pretty big, but these days it's like being outshined by Brood War in terms of like size and everything. And also compared to, like, relative to other esports. You know, I was like, maybe you can actually win this, but then I realized I now get to untap with this. Yeah, this is not happening. They have like so much food on their side of the table. Okay, so let's try what I usually try against this kind of deck these days, which is like heavy discard and trying to get Prochantus to work. Taking out like two of those and then like one of those each. Then I wouldn't hate bringing in a Surgical, but I'm not sure. Maybe Collector Uwe even has a spot. Let's try this. Oh no, they might actually... Did they have black mana? Oh, well, too late. Yorion. This hand could actually be like really decent. Like, I really like this hand, but having Prochantus in hand is actually kind of a big deal since it's such a big part of our strategy. Okay, this is good. This is good. Send this on away, accelerate on the first turn, and then go crazy on the second turn. Well, they can't really stop us except with Force, I guess. And Swords of Plowshares. Yeah, Swords of Plowshares would be annoying. Oops. Yes, the Jumpstart cards are legal online yet, but they are near impossible to find. Like, the estimate right now is that there's like 10 copies, for example, of Allosaurus Shepherd and Magic Online altogether. Yeah, I should have actually let on this one. Okay. Wait, opponent's doing nothing? So we actually get away with this shit. That makes me feel like they might have Plague Engineer in hand. Like, if they have basically no interaction, no first turn play, probably no relevant second turn play, that so much feels like Plague Engineer, which means we need to find this card and or Natural Order. Okay, Okay. Okay, now this is gonna be interesting. Like, I wonder how good the collector oof is actually gonna be. Like, there's a world where they actually farcifully collect oath because they can't, like, get rid of it. But first, I want them to fight over the visionary. Because we got a second one and we got a collector oof. Ooh, and Thoughtseize. Okay. Let's find out, guys. Let's find out. Okay, they literally got shit. This is nothing. Flooded Strength Drop, Bunton Growth. Actually, Abundant Growth was decent against Collector Oof now that I think about it. I guess we take the Oko even though it doesn't really do anything. Let's draw one more card. Yeah, this should probably do it next turn. Seven Barbarian, hey. Servus, something we say in German. Southern Germany, I guess. I guess people also say it in Austria. Okay, you got Abundant Growth, so... Abundant Growth is gone. Well, I guess we can move this down. Chop is gone. Ponda's gone. Come on, give me the shuffle on the Ponda. Didn't shuffle, okay, interesting. No, but we can do, we can manage. Man, we just got so much going on for us here. Are they gonna fight over this? No. Are they gonna fight over this? No. That's like 15 if that reserves. But I wanna get Progenitus anyway. Okay, we won. Easy game. Anything wanna change? Not really. I think we're just gonna go ahead with this. There's a world where they have Plague Engineer, but let's just pretend they don't. Let's see how that's gonna work out. Okay. Really like this end on the draw. On the play, I would have been like, eh. On the draw, I really kinda like this. There's tons of potential to draw what we need. For example, this. It's a little scary that they didn't do anything on their turn. Because now I feel like this is gonna... Just not gonna do too much against the Brainstorm, but we still have to do it. Like, we could have played this, this, and this, and then if we draw one mana, if we also play this, but it's just... doesn't feel good. Oh, straight up Counterspell to the face. Counter me, darling. Counter me, baby. Also, really nice choice of art. This end is so fragile. You'd think this is like really good now, but since we have so little information about what's going on the other side and what they are playing exactly, I'm feeling a little, like it scares me a little bit to commit to the board here. The ginger one? Oh, the alpha beta one? That's also a good one. There's also a DCI version that I really like. I think it was might be an Arena League foil. Ooh! Now how about this? Okay, at least we got rid of the back to basics for one mana. And they still don't know what's on top of the deck, so there's no Terminus coming in thus far. But are the Alpha Beta ones expensive? I would guess they're like $100, right? Something like that. Probably more. One mana him to Torch, and they lose one life. Actually, in this case, they didn't. Okay, we're just gonna commit to the board here. We're gonna commit like crazy. Almost like, we could have played this one as well if we played it first, but... Just don't Terminus me. Imagine getting blind Terminus on this board. Oh fuck, okay. If they had played Brainstorm here, there's really only one thing that happens, and that is us getting Terminus next turn. Snake we can beat. No fucking holy shit. Snakes. Snakes and chitters. This is rough. Like, we literally have no recurse against that except... well, I guess we have a ton of stuff that we can draw here that would be good, but still. We need to draw something very quickly. Oof. Natural order. It's pretty much it. That's certainly not it. Oh god, no. We're getting destroyed by a flying snake with a sword. Yeah, we can even draw a natural order next turn, but it's still gonna be rough. Ba-da-da. Remember when I guys tell you we really want a Lanowife that has reach and legacy? That would have been such a good block. We kill this, and then Chitta can't connect for a turn at least. Yeah, not like this, right? Okay, I guess you could do that. Use it on your upkeep, okay. Yeah, but spiders are like bad. Babello, I wonder, right? It literally makes no sense in the first place. Like, is it carrying it in its mouth? I doubt it actually got like the power and dexterity to like properly wield that chitter. I would probably hurt itself, most of all. Kind of makes no sense. The tail end around the hood. I could see that. But then you still gotta explain to me how the snake is flying in the first place, I guess. I guess it has wings, which... Are they flying? There's actually flying snakes, by the way. No! Oh, fuck! We got fucked. Ba-da-da. It's gonna be really bad. Apparently, there's, like, snakes I've seen that they, like, slither through the air. That's more like elaborate falling, but it's still kinda cool. Also one of the best video game songs of all times. Like the opening scene to Final Fantasy VI. Oh. Honestly, that's one of the best things any human has ever produced in a video game. You always gotta judge it like relative to its time, of course, but this is just outstanding. Can't believe I'm losing to a Stoneblade deck now. You got all this power, you got all the snow power. And you choose it to pair it with Stoneforge Mystic and Batterskull. I mean, we're losing to it, after all. No! Damn, I'm not even sure where we're going from here. Design Mistake Stack. Oh, the Design Mistake Stack, that's the blue Ursa Stumpy deck, right? Wait, end of turn? This is, like, truly the sign of somebody who thinks, like, you know, I just won, I don't care. Oh, it's this. Oh, no, this must be the sword then. Sword of Feast and Famine? Yeah, there it is. Ooh. Oh, no, that make. Oh, god. That means we have to discard, right? Okay, okay. I yield. Great start, huh? Let's do this. There goes my win percentage. Flavor judge and rules lawyer. Is that some kind of training that you have to receive before you can become an officially certified rules lawyer and flavor judge? Can you rules lawyer somebody on flavor judging their stuff? Like, the most classic example of this, everybody knows, right? That's the one. You know the card? Soulless One. It's a blue card that has power and toughness equal to, I don't even know, probably like number of instants in your graveyard or something. And it can be countered, it's a creature, it can be countered by remove soul. Duh. How? Remove soul on Soulless One, it's certainly gonna work. Ooh, opponent! Opponent, you came to the wrong town. You came to Elf Town. And while we still need to draw playoff spells, this is... And we can lose to Death and Taxes, right? I've lost to Death and Taxes plenty of times. I've probably lost more to Death and Taxes than some people have beaten Death and Taxes. Oh god, this is one of those draws where you might actually lose. Yeah, at least we have Reclamation Sage. Ooh, they got Chitta. What if you run out everything? Can't really do that, but we can almost do that. Like, I'd really want to play this morphed. Or do I? Actually, it doesn't really matter to play it morphed. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna run out everything and hope to draw Natural Order.
This is how we do it.
On the other hand, we can actually still wait a turn. This is actually... Okay, yeah. I like where we are here. Wait, state-based effects don't apply? What the fuck? You have 3 Death and Taxes players in your shop? Like, you actually literally have 3 people still playing Death and Taxes? Honestly, your shop should be like, I don't know, certified as some kind of biodiverse national park or something. That's like a place worth protecting. Okay, now here comes the pain. Here comes the pain for us. At least we're only trading 2-for-1 in the chitter after all. We can't do Dryad Bounce. We can't do Dryad Bounce because of Mother and because of Wastelands. Like, if we fetch Dryad, even if they didn't have Mother, they could Wasteland the Dryad. Then we bounce it. I guess we could have, like, 2 Dryads if they didn't have Mother. Yeah, if we use, like, 2 Dryads if they didn't have Mother... I guess you could try and make them use Mother. Hey, you know what? We actually should be. Yeah, we can. Maybe they don't see it. I mean, there's a world where they don't see it. And if they do see it, whatever. Then they can kill like this and this, and that's not the end of the world. I wonder if they're actually not gonna see it. Yeah, I see it. Okay, cool. Cool, cool. You know what Reclamation Sage needs? Reclamation Sage could really use Flash. You already got the upgrade from Viridian Shaman. And, like, I mean, this is 2020. Magic 2020. How does this not have Flash? And Cycling. Okay, you kill this one. And now what? That's fine. I guess if they have Swords of Plowshares, no, even Swords of Plowshares doesn't do it. Split second? Well, that's for 2021. That's already in the pipeline. Dun 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 dun. Pokemon. Pokemon. I would like to destroy this, yes. Uh-oh. Wait, they actually have swords? Okay. Okay, the really correct play would have been to play this one in the first place. Yeah. The really correct play for the people who want to learn is you play this one first, and you go like 1-2 mana, untap this one, bounce, and then they can't do anything about it because then I can bounce and respawns and still replay the land for the third mana. At least you got rid of the Swords of Plowshares that way, I guess. Or they named 4, okay? The real greedy play would have been to get Heritage Druid here, and then draw a Visionary into the Viable Symbiote. Okay, this is good. This is good. I can work with this. What's Word of Seizing? I don't remember that one. Oh, it's a threatened effect that has split second. Oh. Yeah, I guess that could get messy pretty quickly. I'll take it. You can... Word of seizing, not seasoning. But I like seasoning as well. Oh, that's a really good one as well. Okay, here we go. We got another Swords. Maybe we can even beat another Swords. Still good enough. This is probably gonna kill them next turn, right? Oh my god, this song. You guys played Monkey Island? Steel Leaf Champion? Nah, not really. I mean, Hannibal, the thing is, there's, if you wanna see whether a deck benefits from card X, it's not about how good card X is gonna be, because, like, we can imagine plenty of scenarios where Steel Leaf Champion would be such a beating and so incredible, right? It's what you cut for it. So, basically opportunity cost. Like, what do you cut for Steel Leaf Champion? So, which trade-off do you make? where do you make yourself consciously worse? And how does this decrease in power on overall EV compared to the plus EV that the champion adds? And while a champion is decent in a lot of matchups, it's basically like a creature version of Abrupt Decay and what it does strategically. So it's like, eh. Yeah, Steely has been insanely for me. Like when I played it, and I think even was it in Modern? Might have played in Modern as well and felt like really good. So I really love Steelleaf Champion for what it does because it's such a cool card. I'm not sure whether it really has a place in Elves in Legacy. Unless you build like a dedicated beatdown decklist, which is in the cards, right? By the way, we might actually lose if you don't draw enough mana anytime soon. Okay, so they got Butterscar. Oh, okay. Here we go. Now this is gonna be insane. This is gonna be absolutely busted and insane. This is not even close. This is like, this shouldn't be legal. Opponent's like, not this shit again. I can already see Bill Murray.
Go.
Fatality.
How much damage is that gonna be? Like 100 at least. 166. Oh, that's good. Hello, Death in Texas. I haven't seen you in a while. I don't know exactly why. So let's move this and then like one of each here. And yeah. people don't really play, what's it called? Either Swan Canister all that much anymore, do they? Could see taking out one more of those. I like that sausage thing you got there. Pepperoni. Do we have any Americans in the chat? I know that you guys call your pizza with the round slices of meat on it. You call that a pepperoni pizza. In Europe, we call that a salami pizza. Because pepperonis are like what you guys call like chili peppers. And then there's bell peppers, which you guys, I think, also call pepperoni or something. No, basically what you guys call bell peppers, we call paprika. So I wonder, so I understand how all of that like correlates to each other. If you go to like a European restaurant, you order like pepperoni pizza, you're gonna get something like incredibly spicy as opposed to like I think normal salami is more like almost sweet. But now I wonder, after understanding all of this, what actually is salami then? Like if I go to the US and I order a salami pizza, what are they gonna put on my pizza? Like what does salami mean in the US? Race runners? What are race runners? And race runners? Oh, that's actually a card? Okay, 5 GGG. Creature, boar. Oh, that one! I gotta give it to you. That one has, like, amazing artwork. Vigilance, trample, haste, and Anorazor enters battlefield. Other creatures control plus string. Okay, that one's really amazing artwork. I can't say anything about that one. I remember that one. A mildly spicy sausage like pepperoni. Jemise, thank you. Yes, that's. I looked a lot into how cameras and all that kind of stuff works, and I guess they call it a bokeh effect. So if your camera has like, or your lens rather has like a very low aperture, like my got 1.4 on 60mm, which is like really really good. Then you got that the background somewhat blurry, and that looks really cool. Yeah, really like it. Exactly, pepperoni is small red slices of sausages. So what I'm saying is, what do you actually get in the US when you order salami, which is like in Europe, what you get when you order salami pizza, you get like salami, which is like sweet, almost. Salami is more of a sandwich meat. Anyway, oh, what happened to our creature? They killed it.
Triple kill.
I guess we're just gonna run all of those out then. I want to have as much mana as possible next turn, pretty much. They put chili in their sausage and we do not. What? No, I want to eat pizza. I think what Americans call pizza pepperoni, at least in Europe, I don't know if it's actually like in, like, you know how there's sometimes like terms or concepts that you think are from a certain country, but they are not. Like they have like chicken Alfredo in New York or something, and nobody knows what that is in Europe. Like in Europe, I think like when I go to an Italian restaurant in Germany and I order pizza Diavolo, that's like super spicy salami pizza. I guess that's what Americans call pepperoni pizza. Okay, well, let's try this again. I really just want to draw 2 cards and maybe hit a cradle. Like, I don't expect this to win. There's like a, we need to draw like land, Quirin Ranger, or cradle, Quirin Ranger. Yeah, this is, I guess cradle still does something here. This is not cradle. Okay, but we're gonna do something broken next turn. But in speaking of food and how different cultures name them, the most broken thing is the salami thing I get, but it's actually broken. That they like what they call a chicken sandwich, and like I can't even get into that. It pains me too much to like get into it. They call it a chicken sandwich and not a chicken burger. I mean, what is wrong? I remember when I was in China with like Wilson and James, and we ran to a Chinese Burger King and I ordered a chicken burger, and they got it. And then later both James and Wilson told me that they were like, yeah, I noticed you called it a chicken burger. I was like, yeah, because I wanted a chicken burger. They were like, it's a chicken sandwich. Like, no, sandwiches are like cold, and like sandwiches are very different from burgers. But apparently in the US, like, burger does have to be beef. Whereas, like, over here, burger just means, like, grilled patty and then usually some stuff and then something on top and bottom. Or whatever they call it. Okay, this is the slowest game I've ever played. The slowest fast game I've ever played against this kind of deck. So, Iceman, could I like call up Papa John's or whatever they call it? And be like, hey, I'm Julian, I'm from Europe and I want a salami pizza. Can you give me a salami pizza? Where's this?
You must construct additional pylons.
So I just Google image searched it. And this is salami pizza in Europe. This is pizza salami. Can I get that? If I go to, I think it's Papa John's, right? Oh, I guess there must be other ones, like Domino's. Oh, they actually have that? Oh my god! This is like my worst nightmare. But you know, the hilarious part is that we probably still win. But I don't want the small pepperonis. I want the big ones. The small pepperonis are always like spicy. Chick-fil-A? Is this a thing actually called Chick-fil-A? Because honestly, that sounds like a Pornhub channel. Chick-fil-A. That must be on purpose, right? They must be naming that on purpose. There's no way that innuendo is not intended. So much damage are we taking next turn? Like 6? So what if you get Progenitus? That might not even be fast enough. But we can take this one out and then kill them next. Oh, you know what? That might actually be the way to go. Chick-fil-A. Soppressata. Are you Italian? That sounds like Italian. Soppressata. Oh no, by the way, we have Behemoth in hand. I totally screwed this one up. I mean, we were gonna lose anyway, even if I had natural order for Progenitus here, but I guess there's a world where we draw Cradle, but Cradle is like, if they wasteland us, Cradle is gonna be 6 mana. I have no idea what Cassata Cake is.
You must construct additional pylons.
Cassata Cake. Well, that's just like layered cake. Yeah, that's just like layered cake, depending on what's like cream layered cake or something. Man, maybe I should order some food before I get into Valorant later on. By the way, which are the best Valorant champions? My best friend and I, we play actually quite a lot. We've played 14 ranked matches, or 14 like matches together. We lost the very first one. Oh, he even drew Cradle, but I guess it's just not good enough. And then we lost the very first one, and we won 13 times in a row. And I always play the, I think her name is Chet. She can fly and like move really fast. And he plays Sage, and he always like revives me when I die. That's pretty cool. And then the one time I played that girl that like needs to collect orbs from dead people, and she was the worst. She was the worst. Like, I will never play her again. I think I even unlocked her or something. Okay, so how do we win this one? We probably sided out Ooze. Yeah, we sided out Ooze. I guess we need to Elfish Visionary here and draw Heritage to it. Is that going to be good enough? I mean, we have to find out, right? There's no way around it. Yeah, that's not it. Okay, let's win the third game. You're 100% ordering pizza because of this stream. Man, I need to get a pizza sponsor then. I really need to get a pizza sponsor. Corbus makes the best. Corbus is like a pizza place, I have no idea. Sage and which one's Brimstone? Which one's Brimstone? I haven't seen Brimstone yet. Or at least I... Oh, fuck this hand. Yeah, this one. This one's serviceable. Batman. Batman. Did you guys watch, like, the old Batman? I remember, like, in the late 80s, early 90s, I watched that with my dad. When they go fight, and then there's, like, boom, bam, like, these visual effects. I could have natural order for Wirebot, then bounce Birchlaw. Oh, and then replayed and blocked. Yeah. That would have been a sweet play. I'm not sure. Actually, I didn't have enough mana. Actually, I might have enough mana for that. Let's send this one away. That would have been a sweet block because it's colorless, right? Do it, Iceman. I would love to know. He's the older guy with smokes. He can drop from the sky in the bottom. Oh, that's another one my friend always actually plays quite often. Yeah, that one seems like really good. Like the smokes, I love those smokes. Hiding in them and stuff. Oh my god, this is like a proper chain. Opponent, this is how you play creatures. What do you mean your creatures don't draw cards? Confused. Damn GG, almost 2 years. Thank you so much. Damn GG is like, you're like one of my OG subscribers. 23 months, thank you so much. Can't believe it's almost been 2 years now. And one of the best times to tune in. Oh, actually? So we can natural order here, and that's probably what we should do. Kind of want to kill them this turn, but let's... Yeah, we can still keep going. That's 20. And 8 is 20. Then they block, and then they die. Yeah, you know what? We're gonna do that. Let's get rid of this one. Rotter Roof.
Carrier has arrived.
Guess I could have just, like, gone another turn. That should do it. Okay, hey. We found a win. Against our best matchup, probably. Let's see what we can do here. Plague Engineer, you know what? We would still beat that. Scrubland, Simeon Spirit Guide, Plague Engineer. They're down to one life. We have enough attackers. They're dead. But Something that would have been a problem would have been Parish. But even Parish we would probably beat, since he can bounce like two creatures. Yes, I still like Espavile. Even though I haven't played it in a while. Like, the big thing about Espavile, when playing it like every once in a while, is that the matches take incredibly long. So it's not always great for streaming. And it's also not, like, usually, like, when I play off-stream, I watch, like, I don't know, StarCraft or some other esports, or like, a movie, or YouTube, or anything on like, my monitor, and then I just play on the side. And with Espavile, you run into timing issues. But I still really, really, really like the deck. I know that Chef, like, in Espavile chat, he's been experimenting with a lot of stuff. I'm basically kind of still waiting for the next stable release, if you know what I mean. Squalor, thank you. Thank you so much. I recently like made a lot of improvements. Like, if you watch the older-ish ones, they don't have the current setup yet. But you can also check it out on YouTube. YouTube.com/C/itsjulian23, or you just use the link down below that has like a Yoshi and the YouTube logo. And I hope I won't ever get sued by Nintendo or something about that. Like, the best thing to happen to me was that my stream mascot, who is Yoshi, actually went to prison for tax evasion. So I had an easy way out to get rid of him. I'm sorry, Yoshi. That's just like the way it works. Okay, here we go. Koopa Troopa 3. Is that the one that has the purple shell that if you eat it, you can fly? What the fuck, they have 88 cards? What the fuck? Is this gonna be a Yorian deck then? Who arrives at 88 cards in a Yorian deck? I'm not a fan, but since this one is like a decent curve and we're gonna draw basically 3 to 4 cards before we actually need to draw something relevant, kinda like this. We report them for 88 cards, yeah. I guess we could report them for like for 1,488 cards. That would probably crash Magic Online. Ooh, Karagas? Oh no, no, it's... Ooh, no, I hate Mox Diamond. Mox Diamond is always so good against us. Don't challenge me, bro. They're confident. Sorcerer Spyglass, yeah, yeah, good luck. Pippin, I want to see that too. The thing is, there's like 10, maybe 15 copies of that on Magic Online right now because there's... I don't know how Wizards arrives at that. One?
In 5,000.
Treasure chest. If you want a playset, you open on average 20,000 treasure chests. 20,000 treasure chests are worth about... Wait, 20,000 treasure chests are worth almost $50,000. Allosaurus Shredder. What's it called, guys? Chat help me out. Allosaurus. I keep calling it Shredder. Allosaurus. Shepard. By the way, the best thing about that card is it actually taught me how to spell Shepard, because I would always misspell Shepard. Apparently there's like, it's spelled with only E's, and it has two H's in it. It's like so weird. Oh, this is so annoying, now we can't accelerate. Because we already have two dried hours in hand. But okay, let's see how this is gonna go. At least the opponent already played like, minus one card advantage, and this is basically minus one card advantage for now. People say 70 ticks. Like, the bots currently have it listed as 20, but the bots don't have any copies of them, so you can't really compare that. People say, like, 70 ticks, but maybe even more. Like, I think it might even be more if Wizards hadn't already announced that they are selling it for, like, in 3 weeks, they are gonna change the payout of the treasure chests. And at that point, there will be a way to get them easier, hopefully, for all we know. Oh, fuck this. They got this and Wasteland. It's gonna be so good. Yeah, you know what? We're just gonna have to sacrifice the cradle here, basically. I'm just gonna try to run away with the game on a tempo level. That's good. Well, they only have one card in hand after all, so how bad can it really be for us? Sheepherd. Oh, that's actually a really good way to remember it. I need my oil... Yeah, I don't know. I haven't found my oil baron yet, apparently. I saw that last night. I saw that last night, yeah. But yeah, I really want to get my dinosaurs. Okay, I have no idea what's going on here. Banishing Light. Ban me, baby. I was gonna say Nettle Sentinel would be sweet, but actually, is it really that sweet? It's gonna be so hard to make all of this work. At least if we play this, we stop them from playing more lands if they have them. It's not a great plan. It's not actually a plan in the first place. The best plan right now that we got is to draw like more lands that stay on the battlefield and then get Rexage. And once you get Rexage, we destroy them, right? If somebody did donate 50k for me to open 20k chests, well, and get a playset of Shepherds, would you actually spend it on that? First of all, yes, even though 50k would be more than life-changing money for me. The thing is, I'm not sure, like if I used 50k to buy that many treasure chests, first of all, I'm not sure the supply is there. And second of all, I think if I bought that many, the price would actually go up significantly. So I'm not sure I would actually be able to actually buy 20k treasure chests. Like if somebody donated the 50k with the actual incentive or... How would you say that? If somebody donated the 50k... with the stipulation that I spend it on that, I would do that. If it was just like a donation of like 50k and it was supposed to be like, hey, make your life better, I would not do that. I would make my life better and not open 20k treasure chests. Okay, so I have no idea what's going on over there. So apparently they spent all their mana on nothing? Let me... Oh, they put the thing in... I keep forgetting that they can do that too. They basically put the thing in their hand. Okay, that works. So, 1, 2, 3. Oh, fuck, we need 4 mana. Ugh. This is not good for Bitcoin. So, how do we do it? I guess we draw a Heritage Root or Cradle or something. Squatter, I know. That's basically how we do it, right? The thing is, you can only buy a certain maximum of them at the same time, I guess. Like, I've seen that when I bought like a lot of stuff from bots sometimes, like they would, or when I sold stuff to bots, they would only buy a certain amount, and then once I reopened the trade, they would have adjusted their payout. Okay. Well, there's nothing else we can really do here. They can double waste this next turn if they want to. But that would get rid of the city. Yeah, it's not great for them. Yeah, this almost feels like it's a loot box game, right? I honestly think they might have screwed up something, because the way Goldbot explains it, it doesn't really make sense how they changed the drop rate, because the drop rate of 6, which is what our Shepherd has, would have previously been okay. It would have been pretty rare, but not as crazy as this one. But then they shifted some other numbers around relative to it. So they made other stuff much more likely to drop. Which, since the total is always to add up to like 100, now a drop rate of 6 is like really low. So, and they were like really quick to announce the change for the next time they changed stuff. So yeah, maybe they really just fucked it up. would involve many separate accounts and computers. The thing is, like, I understand, yeah, but the thing is, the bots, they only have a certain number of them for sale. So you buy them, even if you have, like, if you open, like, so many transactions, the bots only have a certain number on sale, and that's not anywhere close to what we would need. So we would buy all of their stock, and then we would reopen the trade on all of those accounts. And since we just bought an insane amount, the price would already have shot up, like, quite a lot. Like, I would guess there's maybe some thousands. Like, that's already a lot. I'm not even sure if there's, like, how many thousand treasure chests available right now. Anyway, I still have no idea what's going on the other side there. They got Yorian, and they flickered their Sarum Powder. Okay, I think there's something we can do here. Well, too late. I should have used the mana for this. Hopefully it won't come back to bite me, but I should have used the mana for this. Oh no, it was tapped, right? So it's actually fine. Yeah, opponent's playing some kind of Yorian artifact deck. Not exactly sure what's going on over there. Oh, by the way, we can get this one back as well. We can actually replay this one. This is gonna be good. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Well, there goes good. there goes the entire turn. Well. I guess this is a decent position here. I like how our dog is bigger than their snake. Apparently this is not a snake and this is not a dog, but you know what I mean. It's like Pokemon battlings. Which songs? It's the overture from William Tell. In German we call it Wilhelm Tell. Elves very much back on the menu, yeah. Been doing really well with it lately, even though not in this league. But this round is looking pretty good here. I'm not sure how the opponent's really gonna win. Unless they've got some crazy tech that I'm not aware of. Okay, cool. So let's go for this and that. Like right now, I really just want to get my heritage druid back. So I can have like as much mana as I want and then get Arcane Druid down and like Visionary and everything. Basically destroy them, right? Like their mana is already shit, like super shit. Maybe I should have just gone to destroy two of their mana sources like this and that. Maybe I'm still gonna do that. You know what? I should have played the Visionary first because that might have given me some information or some extra stuff like Glimpse or Natural Order. But yeah. Let's do this. Imagine if you had something that turns everything the opponent has into an enchantment. Then we could go crazy with Rexage. Yeah. What should we put on Arcan? Should we name Sorcery on Arcan? That's probably not good, right? Guess we should name instant, I would guess. Artifact? No, artifacts and enchantments we can destroy with Rexage, so I'm not scared of those. We probably name instant. Like, I want to name sorcery because that's like the more likely mass removal scenario. But that also shuts off like three of our best spells that would win on the spot. So I'm okay naming instant to shut off like brainstorm. And potentially like if we draw a win from the top. I mean, we probably already win by just turning our creatures sideways, honestly. Gonna wait a turn, then we're probably gonna kill them next turn. So next turn, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15. Got Xerxes. Enchanted Evening, yeah. About that. I remember that was like a deck in Standard. Like it was a bad deck. I think it was called Good Evening. Is it called Fractal Gust or something? It destroys all enchantments or something. And you gain a ton of life. So what's going on? Plague Engineer. Is it even scary? Might be. Name Carrier, right? Oh, Human. Don't know what to save. Okay, this is actually a little scary because we... We have no way to get rid of this in the first game. Maybe I'm actually gonna save this. It's actually surprising how much of our stuff still survived. Ooh.
Finish him!
But I can't really do anything about it, right? We name instant. Go, Crotter.
Carrier has arrived.
Plague Engineer, whatever, man. Should be like 50 damage. Let's see if it's gonna be 50. Yeah, they don't block. It is exactly 50? Awesome. What is this deck doing? I feel like we might want all of those. And then I could see taking out, like, once again, like, two cradles, like this, this, and that. And then we're at 60. I wonder if we want this card. It's just, like, so weird, I have no idea what's going on the other side of the board. Sorry. Oh, that was so good. Why do people take drugs and they can't just do this? Oh god, this is beyond compare. Did you guys see anything for Conrad Mana Quest 1? Oh, we're just gonna ship this. I'm in Utopia, I'm in heaven. It's the longest yawn you've ever seen thus far. I like prolonging my yawns. You really get the full belly. Oh no, it's coming again. A little shorter. Oh, is this good? Is this good or is this good? This is the future of yawning. I'm gonna give yawning classes. No, I don't always yawn so long, just when I'm really tired. I rarely ever yawn, I guess. That's what I want to say. But when I do, I go really deep. Apparently the opponent got rid of a couple... No, that's still... Oh! Well... The greedy play is to play Usno. The conservative play is to Arbor here. Let's be greedy. I don't know. I'm feeling a certain level of greed inside me right now. I wanna be the guy who really punishes the opponent for everything. My wife must hate me. Well, tell me if you see her. I've never heard about her. Uh-oh. You're getting engine... Oh, this is amazing. I've actually always wanted to make Tanglewire work in Elves. So yeah, we're basically tapping everything. Actually, oh, I should have responded. Oh, there's nothing to eat anyway. Okay, cool. There's like a bad choke in there, but I'm not gonna make that. Okay. This would have actually allowed us to cast Drexage, by the way. Oh, Tanglewire. Tanglewire, man, this is amazing. Kitchen sink magic. Let's try this. Looks more like an EDH deck. My partners laugh big yawns. I've actually never cared about the intensity or duration of the yawns of my partners. Okay, opponents. So you're sending both of us back to the Stone Age right now. What's your next plan? I guess this also wouldn't have resolved through the chalice. Oh, it's okay, Black Stumpy. This makes like a 1-1 death touch every turn. I mean, rather, it makes one if they don't have one yet. How many do we need to tap? Like 3? Guess I'm gonna tap those then. Then draw Cradle. Ooh. Okay, now we are a little bit of trouble. Turbulence. But we can still get there. Fade away, Tanglewire. Fade away. Just wait until the Fliggers. Oh, no. Maybe that's what they're gonna be up to. They can actually do that. They can, like, put Yorin into the hand this turn and then maybe cast it next turn and then flick out. Oh, they're doing something else, I guess. 4 mana. What's that gonna be? 4 mana human? I have no idea.
Nuclear launch detected.
Sure, sure. God-like. You got braids. Okay, now that's something. I'm loving it. I'm really loving it. I haven't seen braids in like literally 17 years. This is something else. They're easily having 8 times as much fun as we do. True. This is really sweet. So we have to sacrifice first. Oh, that's actually even stacked the right way. So I guess we stack the Bertrand Rangers. And then we have to... Okay, so there's a world where we draw... So I can either grow the ooze of the mana here. Or I can tap these two. And draw... Yeah, I think we just tap it. I was gonna say if we draw Cradle, but then it would still natural. Okay. So what's the plan here? Probably do nothing, right? First of all. And then we'll figure it out. I would guess. Oh wait, they sacrificed chalice. Oh no, tap chalice. Yeah, she's doing some good ruining right now. We will probably abrupticate a chalice, then sacrifice a land, and or sacrifice ooze even. I don't even know, guys. We can't get rid of the girl, so we have to outrace her or something, which we can do. It gets problematic once the opponent has like pitch cards for a force field or something, but is that really gonna happen? The name Bird, by the way, what the fuck? Is this a bird? No. Is this a bird? It's a bird serpent. Uh-oh. Another big thing coming in. Play a second Braids, do it. For science. I guess there's another Braids that they could play, but... Oh god, Smokestack. Okay, now we gotta finish this game hard and quickly. Oh, there's gonna be infinite triggers on the upkeep here. Yeah. Opponent, you stack them. Do whatever you want. I just wanna keep Dryad Arbor and Bayou. Okay, first of all, we have to sack and then we have to tap something. We're gonna sack the Schleimbatzen ooze. Then we're gonna tap this. Get a thing, and then that does nothing. I guess if you draw Glimpse here, we can actually win. Okay, that's not Glimpse, but it's still okay. I can get this one down. You know, we can actually Natural Order here. Should we do that? Is that gonna be good enough? There's a world where this is gonna be good enough. Can we actually kill them here now that I think about it? Probably not. So we can go like this, untap this, replay this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's like 10, 16. We can almost kill them here. That's... I don't know, guys. I kind of want to kill them. Let's see if we can kill them. Oh, it's not looking like a kill. One, two, three, four, five, six. So it's 11 and 7. It's 18, so they have to block. Guess we just... Just get Chantus here. Yeah, Chantus should be good enough. I'm just scared if they have like more smokes effects and stuff. There's like a world where it could get dicey. By the way, Parades should really have Death Touch. A profile picture reminds me so much of April on Twitter. You know, April has got like these two accounts, like the proper one, and the one where she tweets about sex that all the Wizards and players follow. And then all of a sudden they remove that other streamer from the content creation program, even though like everybody like cherishes April, rightfully so, for her like lewd April Twitter account. Talk about hypocrisy. They tap. So what's the worst that could happen? They could put a smokestack. So they basically had like double smokestacks, right? I guess Wasteland would be an annoying start. Wasteland, yeah, you know, Wasteland plus Plague Engineer. That would be devastating. Yeah, we're definitely gonna get rid of this as soon as we can. Is this gonna be? Ooh, Karn, that could be a problem, right? There's a world where they get like ensnaring bridge with Karn, and then once the ensnaring bridge comes down, we might not have enough permanents to sack anymore. Engineered explosives, okay. Oh, that's also annoying. So if they have engineered explosives, what I want to get is oof. Oof, oof, oof. Oh, this is gonna be so tough. Oh, they can blow it right away. Oh, fuck.
Nuclear launch detected.
Well, it really only kills Symbiote, but it's still gonna be rough. Martin, depends on like where. On Magic Online, 60 would already be insane. 60 would be really good on Magic Online. In paper, if it was like only Legacy paper 60%, I would not be happy, but Magic Online 60% would be like really good. So how's this game is gonna go? How's this game gonna go? We lose like this and that. No, we can't lose this. We lose this and that. Then we play, yeah, I guess that's how it's gonna go. But 70 on Magic Online is not really feasible in the long run, at least in Legacy. I guess you could try, but it doesn't sound like something that's actually gonna happen. Like 60, 65 would be 65 would probably make you one of the most successful players in Magic Online. Okay, now we get to destroy a bunch of stuff. You can probably like calculate what like a reasonable percentage and stuff would be. Considering that your elo in Magic Online is kind of based on that. For example, like very, 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 very few players in the history of Magic Online have gotten to like 2000 plus elo. Like the only ones I really remember was Daniel Gacha when he went on this super insane run lately. And Marcus Ewald when he played Top Miracles. I think Top Miracles accounts for like 80% of the people who ever had like 2000 plus elo. Okay, so the only thing that really makes sense is the smokestack, right? On the other hand, maybe it should have been the Georian? Ooh. Oh no, the smokestack is dying now. The Tanglewire is dying now, right? So it makes sense. I wonder if I want to kill the Karn here. I'm so scared that Karn might do something that just destroys us. Even though it means we need to attack twice. They must have Ensnaring Bridge, right? In paper, I can't tell you. In paper, it's so heavily depends on your tournament selection, right? At my LGS, 70% would be like, yeah, wouldn't hate that. Wouldn't mind if it was higher. Even though I guess it also heavily depends on the LGS. Like I've been to LGSs where you play like with people like multiple Grand Prix top 8s, Ruins, Bazaar of Moxens, everything. And then I played at LGSs where people played Standstill after I played Turn 1 Wild. So it's really hard to say. I'm not that concerned, honestly, with win percentage. I'm more concerned with like winning tournaments. That sounds like cringy and but I really mean it. I think the obsession with win percentage always leads to people playing more conservatively when they should play more aggressively to win a tournament. But that really depends on what you want to do in Magic. Like I value winning one, for example, card market tournament higher than getting like three top eights or something. Even though like there's much more variance that goes into that, and like if you look at that, that's like a much bigger achievement to get like those three top eights as opposed to winning one tournament. But to me, in the end, what really counts is winning the tournament, and that's just like such a great big thing to remember. Whereas like top eights is also great, but I guess speaking of greatness, I want to go the extra mile and get that tournament win. And at that point, you're really not talking that much about like necessary being the better player anymore, because the top 8s are like super variance prone. Fuck, they got it. Okay, now we gotta find Wirebird Symbiote. It's not that crazy, right? Opponent going to timeout. Oh, that's actually a thing that might happen, right? Even Sunnet would do it, I guess. Okay, that doesn't do it. Might still need to run it out anyway. Contact the progenitors. Smart. By the way, when are you gonna start streaming Natural Order? Didn't you mention that you wanted to? We had all the buy now. Whoa. Hey, birds 7,770. Thank you so much. Thanks for gifting. How many? Oh, to Michael Benson. Welcome to the Glimpse Chain. I just saw something. I got 5 new emotes. I have no idea how it works with emotes. I have so many emotes now. I got like, I don't know. Where is it? I got this and that and that. But my favorite one is probably still this one. Oh, where is it? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh no, I already screwed it up. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I misclicked. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh god, this is... 1, 2, 3, 4. This is not working the way I wanted to. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Keanu. You deserve better. You deserve much better. Oh, there's Astro Spyglass. So if this name's Wildwood Symbiote, then our only outs are like 2 Abrupt Decays. Or maybe the opponent not being able to cast their spells or something. But that's gonna be hard. I guess even that wouldn't work because they can never have 10 cards in hand. Yeah, you can't really stream from a laptop. Especially their sound quality is gonna be awful. I feel like every time I watch streams from laptops, the sound quality is just like so bad. Quarian Ranger, okay. Bold strategy. Yeah, that's not it. Can we kill Karn here? No, we can't. Yes, we do have 2 outs actually if they spyglass Twilight Symbiote. We have 2 Abrupt Decays should be 2 Abrupt Decays left in the deck, right? Yeah. So there's 2 Abrupt Decays left in the deck that would probably win the game almost on the spot. There's like a scenario where they can get... Oh, they're animating this, okay. There's a scenario where they can get Tomat Script with Karn and then Tomat Script themselves to hit the Ensnaring Bridge and then get the Ensnaring Bridge back with Karn, but that requires so many loyalty counters and that's probably not happening. Unless we draw the thing very, very late. Opponent's really down to 5 minutes. Is this? Which game is this, by the way? Is this the second game? O-Ring. Uh-oh. Well, we still have 2 decays out. I'm actually not gonna fetch here. Because if they eventually find Wasteland and like raise the recurrent, then they can get rid of all our black sources and I wanna play the Bayou here. Oh, there's one in the graveyard already? Okay, never mind, then I can fetch. They play with Pete Bog, that's pretty cool. Okay, if this is game 2, then I'm looking forward to game 3. They have Sorcerer Spyglass, but it names Quirin Ranger and apparently it also can't attack. No, I changed my overlay that I can easily disable my webcam, so what if I do like this? Man, this is amazing. as the song has to go. Big Hydra. 4 minutes. Guess I'm gonna have 6 here. Would be hilarious if they flickered the Oblivion Ring. Do it! For science! Those are spiders, okay. There's actually a world if you get rid of Ensnaring Bridge where they might even race us. But probably not. Since we are the first ones to get in 2 attacks. Okay, now the name Wirewood's in bed. Yeah, that's a little too late. Check out if this. Decay! No decay. Okay. This point is gonna be a little bit hard. On the other hand, are they really gonna like win this and the next game in 2.5 minutes? Kevin has run to a different screen capture. You're right! Which one would that be? Oh, I know which one that is. That is the one for floating mana. Bottom bar. One of floating mana. Yeah. Okay, perfect. Lettuce. Okay. And then how are you gonna kill me under lettuce? Look at this. Progenitus all gray, all faded away. It's totally disabled. It's colorless, can't attack. Activate abilities cannot. Okay. Like this one, maybe? What if you. No, I guess we can't even use a replica anymore at this point. It's cradle.
Congratulations, you are
5 minute warning!
That's the one. You can still attack, right? So they need to get rid of their own ensnaring bridge to kill us. I guess what they can do is just like sit behind braids and eat up all of our stuff. Until we eventually just like can't do anything. I mean, we already can't do anything anymore. I guess the opponent's win condition would be to make us sack all of our stuff. And oh yeah, so since they can make us sack all of our stuff and have Trinisphere, that means that we will never get to 3 mana, so we can never play a spell, so they can safely go up to whatever like cards in hand they need and then safely kill us this way. Yeah, right now I'm still racing them with Enchantress. So I guess if they wanted to kill us quicker, they would have needed a smokestack or something. Pawn says, thanks for playing, Julian. Was an honor. Thanks, you too. Say good luck next round. Yes, they already have letters. But we can still win. We can still attack with under letters. That's why it takes them so long to establish everything board. So can we get, after the rough start, can we still salvage this league and get the 3-2? So if you want to watch more of my stuff while we're waiting, check out on YouTube, youtube.com/c/itsjulian23, or click the link below. You can also sub on my Patreon, patreon.com/itsjulian23, which really, really helps me out with creating all this content, whether it's a podcast, it's the leagues that I run, the tournaments that I do, or sometimes even playing goofy decks on stream. If you want to submit a donation deck list, you can do that down below as well. And yeah, that's something. You can also follow me on Twitter, twitter.com/itsjulian23, which is like basically where Legacy takes place, right? You gotta be on Twitter for that. And yeah, check out the Everyday Channel podcast. We got the new episode coming out with the creator of the new... Well, I don't know if he's considered the creator, but he's basically the overlord of the new World Gotcha Dragon deck that he just won the last challenge with. That was like one of the coolest, best flowing episodes we ever had. It's gonna release either... It's probably gonna release tomorrow, since I'm gonna edit it tonight, and then we're gonna put it up tomorrow. That's also gonna be on itsjulian.com, which is basically where all my content airs. Except for my OnlyFans. There's a secret way to get access to my OnlyFans, but I can't tell you about how. Opponent playing Yorian Snow Miracles according to the bot. Last seen 20 days ago, that's how long it took them to untap that deck. Oh, they're double queuing in a Legacy League? What? You can only play one Legacy League at a time. Should you get more coffee, Bert? I don't know. I've never had a single sip of coffee in my entire life. Okay, this is an interesting version of Snow. The Cabra Therapy must miss here. Coffee's your life, but I don't know, man. I find coffee disgusting. Would you ever drink coffee if you, like, imagine you're like a caveman and you live in human society before we established, I guess, what we would call society today. And you encounter coffee in nature. Like a brown liquid. Like if you see that like in a swamp or something, would you think that's like drinkable? Probably not. And that's why I have an issue with coffee. It's also why I have an issue with cucumbers. Especially, like, if you encounter cucumbers in nature, like the pickled ones especially. I guess they're like human made. They don't grow like that, do they? I literally don't know. Would you eat those? They look poisonous as fuck to you. Like, and if you taste them, they're like the most bitter thing you've ever tasted. And stuff tasting bitter is usually an indicator for it like being poisonous. So I would never eat those if I was like growing up. And somehow our civilization has established that you can drink coffee and eat cucumbers. And to me, it's the most disgusting thing I could ever imagine. I've never had coffee in my entire life ever. I couldn't get myself to do that. You always pronounce my nickname Julian. Jul 1, 2, 3, what the fuck? I've never got that. Jul 1, 2, 3, okay, I've never got that. I'm not sure I'm following, but I like it. You were wondering what's going through head of first person to eat chicken eggs? Yeah. Like, any eggs in the first place, right? What's wrong with people? You drink coffee before milk? But yeah, coffee is like so unnatural, and it smells like poisonous and stuff. Yeah, I wanted not that. That's really weird, yeah, that's a really good point. Like, I also didn't drink milk for... I didn't drink milk until I was like almost 30. Like, I guess I would have like cereals with milk, but I would never drink the milk afterwards, and I found it so disgusting. You know what? Maybe we should just attack here, like, whatever. This is like the most random attack ever, but, I mean, what's gonna happen? I would never drink the milk afterwards. I know that, like, a lot of people, they eat their cereals and then they drink the milk from the bowl. And I still don't do that to this day because I find that disgusting. But today, at least, like, if I have, like, fresh milk I buy from the supermarket, I can, like, take a sip and drink it, and it's actually not bad. What do I think about my opponent's hand? I think it's a lot of lands, removal spells, and hopefully no payoff. Because if their payoff was more than 4 mana, we just enabled it. But yeah, it looks like lands and removal spells. Because right now we haven't really presented anything they really want to remove. Also, we got the... Go, go, Power Rangers! The double morph. Do they know about the second cradle? They might actually know about the second cradle. Oh, it's a Lurn! Oh fuck, this kills me, right? A Lurn plus Recruiter should be a kill. Let's see if they get it. But they should have it. Oh, Nyambi, Esteemed Speaker. That's a new one. So it bounces it and you, like, gain life or something. Okay, makes sense. Then you can get, like, tons of stuff and just kill me. I guess my mother did breastfeed me, Iceman, if you want to know these details. But I didn't really have an actual say in that. Yeah, there's Strix, and then they can basically... Whatever I... Okay, and then they got... Okay, that's good enough. Dazzy's good. You know what I hate Alurum for? Like, I love the card. Just playing against the deck is so annoying. Because it's so hard to sideboard against Alurum. Because obviously a Replica is really bad against them. But because of their color combination, they actually, like, have a lot of stuff you want to Replica. But maybe I just want to be, like, a discard person here. Let's try this. You forced me to consent stuff I didn't want. Well, the thing is, like, in German law and German constitutional law, the way it works is your basic rights granted by the constitution, I think it's Article 1 through 20 or something. There's always an interesting question that is, like, at which age do the basic rights that are granted through the constitution apply to you in the sense that you are actually the one making the calls? And the answer really is, from a constitutional law point of view, the answer really is as soon as you can actually exercise those laws. As soon as you can become, like, conscious of them and use those basic rights that the constitution grants to you. I always found that interesting, like, an interesting concept. Because it's very practical. Uh-oh, they must have one of those two, right? I mean, unless they want to go really crazy and name, like, Rexage or something. I would love to try out the Orosaur Shepherd. I would really love to try out the Orosaur Shepherd. The problem with that is... There's less copies of those available than there's, like, I don't know. But I guess Bars of Gold is a bad comparison because there's probably, like, a lot of them on the world. But yeah, I guess you get what I mean. There's very, very few. There's, like, between 10 and 20 estimated. Oh, Lawful Age is a totally different concept from what I just explained. Okay, so next turn we got an attack for, I don't know, 19 or something. 1, 2, 3. So we got, like, 9 and 6 is 15 plus. Oh, 20. Yeah, yeah, because this is a 2/2. Assuming they got nothing, right? But how likely is that gonna be? No Veteran Explorer one time? Okay, cool. Ooh! Yeah, that still is... This is really good. Now they basically need like 2 removal spells or something. Pond is like, I've seen enough of this shit. Let's go to the next game. Sign me up. I'm down. Still gonna be rough because Arkan really wants to name enchantment here. But then they probably still have some kind of like flying death touches, which is gonna make it awkward. Otaba, are they from Japan, or are they based in Japan? There's like some famous Japanese magic grinders that I only recently learned are, from Japan. Like Sylvie Wataru or something? I've played against that person like so many times and I only recently learned that they're from Japan. And then I started following them on Twitter and of course they posted like all these Japanese characters, but then when you hit translate, you get like a rough idea of what they're saying, right? A Japanese Aluren pilot in like the Japanese Aluren Air Force. It sounds I'm a Japanese Aluren pilot. What do you pilot? Well, I pilot like, I don't know, an F-22. Well, I pilot Aluren. Best Game Boy game? Wait, which one? I already forgot what we were just listening to. But it was probably like Link's Awakening, right? Link's Awakening is generally considered one of the best Game Boy games. Oh man, so many things with this hand. I really, really want to fetch Dryad Arbor here. I kind of really want Cavatherapy, but not necessarily. I think I'm going to fetch Dryad Arbor here. But I'm also going to do this. I mean, what's the worst thing that could happen in 3 mana, really? I mean, that's like infinite things that 3 mana would destroy us. Like this, for example. Oh god, shit, I hate this. And we have no Abrupt Decay. Oh, fuck this. This card is stupid. How does Wizards print that? Wizards... The person who created this card hates everything and anything that's beautiful in the world. They hate beauty. Maybe I should have like chemotherapied it or something, I don't know. Basically wanna draw a land here. Okay, cool. So now what I really wanna do is accelerate into another Dryad Arbor so I can top deck Natural Order next turn. But maybe it's better to name Aluren here. And then we can flashback for like removal spells and then 2 turns from now do Natural Order thingy. Okay, they get Kotal and Harpy. That's not scary. Yeah, and the problem about Plague Engineer is that it's so much more playable, right? Because it's a creature and has Death Touch. Like, it's applicable in so many more matchups. And that's why it became such a mainstay. I can't believe it. This is something else. And the mana cheaper. No, it's the same mana cost. They both have the exact same mana cost. Yeah, like if it was 1 BB, it would still see play. I think that wouldn't be enough to stop it. Yeah, I guess you say if it still had to exist. I think if it still had to exist, it should be like an enchantment carrier at least. Huh, I'm an enchantment carrier. I carry enchantments. Honestly, though, if we can top deck Natural Order, we are not that far from like winning, maybe. Okay, now they got really nothing. So let's glimpse here, draw, I don't know, something. Cradle or so. Okay, land is good. Then do we accelerate? We don't even need to. Do I want to trade these? You know what, I want to trade these. Is this one actually going to do something? Like, I care more about this, almost. This one can actually give me ooze, now that I think about it. Which land did they play? They played Misty Rainforest, so this one's gone? Okay. What if he gets ooze? What got printed Megalurin a thing again? I guess Snake. Icewind Codal. I mean, it already was like a thing, and it's not like a tier 1 thing any- Oh, it's gone, okay. It already kind of always was a thing, like, on and off. Yes, champions are bad. Any kind of lords are really bad to fight Plague Engineers. Forest Walk is really cool. I really like the Forest Walk. I've always liked the Forest Walk, especially, like, when everybody was playing Deathwatch Champion with Buck, well, Buck or even four color thingies. It's just like the lords are so bad against engineers that we can't really use them because they don't have enough other utility on top of that. Well, we do see more Alluren as of recently. I think it's not a coincidence. People started playing more Alluren because in the Snow Shell, you can play a lot of stuff in the Snow Shell. I mean, you also see World Guard Hard Dragon, which is also kind of using the Snow Shell. Wait, are you gonna put that on something else now? Okay. I hope they named Forest or Dryad here. Ah, damn. Actually, I shouldn't fetch the second Dryad out because they can easily kill that. If they do it next turn. So, Natural Order one time. Okay, at least this one sticks around. For now. Cradle. We're surprisingly deep, still deep into the game, right? You can even flashback for, actually, unless they kill a creature here. Oh, and we're down to 5? How did that happen? We thought seized, we've used some fetcher. We are down to fucking 5. I'm not even sure if we're winning this. I guess if you draw Natural Order, we kill them for a sec- not anymore. Watch us draw Natural Order now. Or Behemoth, even worse. Okay, yeah, this one was not meant to be. I'm sorry.